few weekends later, Pauline has mastered the slider, and she's moved a stage further, to a glider that really does glide. She's ready for her first cautious ascent into the air. A toed glide, just a few feet high to give confidence and teach the proper use of all the controls. Now, says the chief instructor, if you ease the stick back gently, you'll fly. Good work, Pauline. And now, where's Peter? A little more practice needed there. By the following week, Pauline has made several flights. She's mastered takeoffs and landings. With each hop, she feels more at home in the air. From low hops of 6 feet or so, she's gone on literally by leaps and bounds. Now she's towed up to over 100 feet. The cable is slipped, and she's left to fend for herself. Steady, steady. And she's down to a neat, smooth landing. The retrieving car arrives. Now the aircraft is taken back to the launching site, where the next pupil waits to try his wing. Straight for the winch when you're airborne, says the instructor. Otherwise, it was a good flight. Peter, still firmly attached to the slider, and dear old Mother Earth, grimly clutches the stick and wishes it were a tankard of Old and Mild in the club bar. Here, more fortunate members refresh themselves and shoot lines with equal enthusiasm. Here, the aviator's problems are debated. How to tackle the inside of a thundercloud. How to pick up the Derbyshire wave, which has carried pilots up to over 10,000 feet. Here the plans for a super glider take shape. Here the bright ideas, the latest prang, the meat and drink of flying life are all enjoyed in an atmosphere of good fellowship, tankards and tobacco smoke. Next door, in the club room, there's more serious business to be done. Flying notices to read. A contour map of the area to study. Here's the steep hillside up which the wind rushes to lift an aircraft hundreds of feet a minute. Your girlfriend may be impressed. But not so much as these young pilots who listen to an instructor's tale of a flight of 150 miles he made a few days before. It's a story of skill and nerve. 150 miles on the wings of the wind, over towns, over rivers, forests, mountains, a five-hour battle through rain, storms, and cloud, seeking out the up currents to carry the glider those few precious feet higher, higher to fly a mile further, higher to get out of danger. On the field, training goes on. Pupils at all stages along the road to the coveted badge of the qualified glider pilot are taking off, gliding, soaring, landing. Taking off, gliding, soaring, nanny. Pauline, with over a dozen ascents in the primary glider to her credit, now starts flying a more advanced aircraft. The instructor tells her to make a slow, steady circuit and land. It doesn't sound much, but all that she's learned in the past few months will be needed now. That's it. It's all over. I'm done.
Phew.
Good old Earth. Peter doesn't think the Earth's so good. Peter's instructor doesn't think Peter's progress is so good. A few weeks later comes the real test for Pauline. Her logbook shows that she's getting on well. She's gained the A and B certificates and is quite at home in the air. A natural flyer, thinks the instructor. She's calm and she doesn't get flustered. I think she can try for her C test. A C test is a duration flight of at least 5 minutes. That may seem a very short time, but it needs all the skill and experience of handling aircraft gained after months of effort. The Committee of Senior Instructors agrees that Pauline is qualified to try for her C. Tomorrow, if there's a west wind. Well, this is it. A big moment in a glider pilot's life. Listen to your instructor. Look at the hard black silhouette of the winches half a mile away. Fasten up your helmet. Keep calm. Don't get flustered. A sudden jerk and she's airborne, climbing swiftly to 500 feet. Over the winch, she pulls a knob on the instrument panel and the towing cable is released. Now she's alone. Hundreds of feet over the dales in a frail canvas box. She feels the lift of the rising air as she steers over Bradwell Edge. The controls move continuously under her fingers, counteracting the thrust and buffet of the wind. She must keep her airspeed steady at 30 miles an hour. She must watch the horizon, the smoke from the villages, watch the altimeter, the little red ball which tells her whether she's rising or falling. Watch, correct, watch again, recorrect, watch, always watch. Look below for a second. There's the hangar and the clubhouse, and somewhere down there is the chief instructor timing the flight. 5 minutes. She's done it. She's got her C. Good going, Pauline. Peter, a mass of bruises from riding his all too faithful steed, is the first to congratulate her. Back at the clubhouse, a more boisterous welcome awaits the newly fledged pilot. But it's all good fun. And presently they sit down to tea in the highest of spirits. Peter sits down very, very gently. And so work goes on in this schoolroom of the skies, where boys and girls, young men and old, learn to outfly the soaring birds. Launching by elastic ropes, pulled by eight brothers in arms. Catapulted into the air. Launching by winch and cable, with a swift upward surge, somehow into the air. It's a great sport, gliding. There's the song of the wind in your ears, the feel of a machine of grace and beauty at your fingertips, the thrill of aerobatics in fine sailplanes. It's you against the forces of nature, the essence of all true sports. One day, Peter, you too will ride on the wings of the wind. One day.